My friend and producer Denis Poncet was in Paris together with me. We were having oysters. And when we had the 14th or 15th oyster, he said, "Is the Romy Schneider story over for you?" And I said, "Yes." But, and then he looked at me, and then I saw that I had to add something else, and I said, maybe at the exception that it would be sort of a zoom at the end of her life, a sort of description of her being, of her situation at the end of her life, of this icon. And then at the very end, he had the idea of shooting a film with only four actors, four persons, with the fifth protagonist, which was Brittany, telling about 3 days in Quiberon, at the center of the story, this interview with the German magazine Stern. And I thought that was very interesting. And then he asked me about Emily Artif, what do you think of her? And I said, wonderful, I really like her. And then these two started to write.
Through 3 days in Quiberon,
it's quite clearly not a documentary, and nor is it a reportage. It's a feature film. I didn't feel any fear about that. The images and the interview weren't about Romy Schneider as a myth. They were about Romy Schneider as a human being, about the woman Romy Schneider, Lebec. And his wife Cordula gave me all of the prints. I had 600 images, so more than 500 or so that had never been seen. I had all of the negatives. It was an absolute gift for a filmmaker. I had photos of all of my characters, the other characters as well, which are very, there's also other important figures. Robert Lebec had enormous trauma when he was a child, and that was something that was very important for me, the idea of going out into the world, being so curious, subconsciously driven, always wanting to look at what's happening out there in the world. That's what drove him, made him so curious about people, about actors, celebrities, about all of these documentary reportages. He had a very close relationship with Romy Schneider. If everything has been written, it's true, but he's also talked about it himself. And so you end up with this kind of conglomerate as an actor, and you offer that to the director, in this case to Emily, and see if she says it's okay or not. I would wish I could have met him. He was a real cosmopolitan figure and such a cheerful, positive person as well. That's what I kept on hearing about him, that he had this amazingly positive way of looking at people and wanted to convey that through his photographs. So I really enjoyed engaging with that kind of person for 12 months. It makes you a bit more cheerful yourself as well, it has to be said. 1981 was a very difficult year for her. And I wanted to show this woman who was in a sense broken, but at the same time had this urge to live. And even if it's perhaps just an afternoon or a week, just a few days, I wanted to depict a glimmer of hope and peace as well. If Denis Poncet had asked me to make a traditional biopic about her entire life, I would have said no. Something quite different to look at the last year of her life as well. Just a few months after those 3 days in Quiberon, her son died, and I wouldn't have made that film either. I wouldn't have wanted to make that film. The fear of this cinematic legend was certainly there. It was latent in me while I was preparing and during the shooting as well. What carried me forward was the great clarity with which Emily and I both said that we're trying to present a sort of proxy moment, a surrogate moment that symbolized a great deal more. I focused on details a little bit, on the language. But after thinking about that, I thought, no, I just want to act freely. I don't want to think about whether I'm moving or acting like this actress. I didn't want to run the risk of imitating her at all. And I said, the only way it can work is if you manage to move beyond that, to go a step further.
Sozusagen noch mal mehr, als es sowieso schon seit Jahren der Fall ist, immer wieder mit dem Romy-Schneider-Thema konfrontiert werde, dann sage ich mal,
with Romy Schneider for many years, and if that's even more the case now, I have to say that's just the way it is, but I have to say, I'm not really worried about that in this context.